Christmas, I believe. And our plan was that I would color all of the pages, and then he would finally read the short stories to me. But that never happened. I never got around to coloring all of them. They're pretty intricate. They're very detailed. And if you guys really like this and I continue, maybe you'll see the ones that I have already colored. I love short stories so much. Make something up stories you can't unread by Chuck Palahniuk as well. But I know some people are not a fan of him because his writing can be very, let's just say, risque. But I do. If you guys really, really like short stories, there is an author out there. He's a small author. I cannot find any of his books to rent at my local library, and it's a pretty big library system. But his name is Jason Ockert. I've read both of his short story books. They're called Neighbors of Nothing. Surprise. like it was rolling in slow motion to destroy them, and superimposed over the image was her full name. At first, the television called it the meteor from the Sabrina solar system, until they shortened it to the meteor Sabrina Tabitha St. Martin, until they kept just saying, Sabrina is due to reach our atmosphere in 38 days. Cable News got a hold of her parents and flew them all to New York first class with a suite at some big name hotel. They rode everywhere in a limousine, and Sabrina appeared on different shows like the Today Show and Bill O'Reilly, until that was a big mistake. Until to say people were hostile was an understatement. Until it wasn't like naming her own hurricane. It was like Sabrina was the catalyst. Until when she left the Today Show, crowds outside Rockefeller Center fought each other for a chance to spit on her limousine window. Until everything was about to be wiped out, and people in social studies lands and diverse ethnic cultures shook their fists at the sky and cursed the only name they could talk in English, her name, Sabrina Tabitha St. Martin. Until every night the meteor got bigger in the telescope, brighter, more than a dead nothing, but not something she wanted to come any closer. Even worse than everyone dying and nobody getting even one more Hanukkah or Christmas or Ramadan, until everyone became eligible for a Make-A-Wish Foundation vacation with free airfare to Disneyland, and until everyone deserved the front place of every ticket line to every ride at Disney World. Worse than all the bunnies in Scottish Folds getting blasted to smithereens by the impact of huge space junk, the worst was how Sabrina's personal webpage morphed into a solid sheet of haters blaming her in every language. Sabrina already had body image issues galore. She didn't need some Montana-wide asteroid hurtling toward the Earth with her name on it. Until zero-tolerance anti-bullying policies or not, all the kids at Harriet Tubman Middle School, every kid without a future, texted it was her fault, until her webpage got so many hits, but like people were punching her in the face, until their mean comments got her account frozen, until trolls the world over hacked her site and doctored her selfies with memes and dialogue balloons, until she was smiling and saying, yes, I eat shit all day, until even the JPEG of her as a four-year-old, naked in a bubble bath with bubbles on her head like a foamy crown and rubber duck in her chubby hands, until even that little Sabrina was saying, hi, I'm Sabrina Tabitha St. Martin, and I've had a million penises inside me. Her real star, the dead one, was in the constellation Pupus. She looked it up, an Italian word for poop. It referred to the big poop deck at the back of an old-timey sailing ship, like in Christopher Columbus times. The constellation was one of several that combined to outline a big ship named after the Jason and the Argonauts movie, but nobody wanted to hear the truth. All they had heard was her star was in the poop constellation, until everyone claimed she had some inside track on the impending killer meteor situation, until even Wikipedia said she and the meteor Sabrina were in cahoots, until people claimed it was witchcraft, like calling to like, as if she were summoning the meteor, conjuring it, until finally her mother took her to the mall to find the right kitten, kind of a weak gesture considering how the Earth was about to be annihilated, and all humanity blamed her just because her parents had cut corners and gifted her a cheap, unstable star. Not fair. Major not fair. Her bunny Sabrina was dead, and nobody would be her friend until she was dead too. Until her and her mom found stores where a credit card to or not. Until getting pregnant didn't matter. Until getting arrested or herpes or AIDS or slut shaming didn't enter anyone's mind. Until the Forever 21 was on fire. Until Sabrina's mom could hear glass breaking. Until gunshots from Cinnabon. Until she said, "You know your father meant well, don't you?" Until Sabrina went back to the farm animal website and they were still posting the old picture of the shirtless boy cuddling her dead birthday present. That boy was probably her dad's age by now, and the bunny Sabrina had been cooked and eaten before Sabrina was ever born. It was weird to think that even before she was born, before the earth had cooled and her parents had fallen in love and the dinosaurs roamed, her doom was already set in motion. Her meteor had been coming to kill her since before she was alive. Again, not fair. Looking at the situation that way, she'd never had a chance. Until one night she woke up, coughing in bed, smelling smoke, until another scary idea came to her mind. Her dad never put back the smoke detector battery before tonight, until the house had been surrounded by people who, before Meteor Sabrina, had been their nice neighbors, until these same neighbors had bought into the idea Sabrina was a witch, until they torched her house, and the flames filled every room, until Sabrina had to climb out her bedroom window and stand in the backyard waiting until her parents would show. Until they didn't. Until no firemen arrived to help. Until Sabrina Tabitha St. Martin was an orphan. Until the last place to go was the cabin at Oak Lake. Under the night sky, she looked up at the stars like fireworks. Until she could see what her father had been trying to teach her all along. That life was brutal and cruel, and only lasted until a person screwed up once, or until some secret destiny arrived to extinguish a little girl. Until Sabrina could see the way grown-ups see the world. Until her arms and legs grew numb from the forest cold. Until finger by finger, this was how it would feel to lose her whole body. Until her father was correct in saying life itself was a brief, absurd aberration and only existed for a pathetic flash until it was canceled by the frigid vacuum of outer space. Until it only seemed inevitable that everything dies and everyone dies. Until her mom and dad being dead was the unhappy natural order of things. Until Sabrina lifted her dead arms as if to welcome the meteor Sabrina, her other self, to embrace the blackness she saw looming above her. Until Sabrina could imagine her dad saying, "Everybody wants to be John Holmes until he gets a kidney stone." Until she grasped that this was a story for grown-ups, with people dying and wrestling with the painful realities of life. Until every sentence was filled with suffering and hard-edged social realism, until it was so burdened with brutal, factual, inevitable injustice, until it could only end by being published in the pages of the New Yorker. Until Sabrina Tabitha St. Martin could see that this was no longer her father's story. Until the massive, dark harbinger of death that descended upon her. It became a whirling shape, that blurred shape without sound, with a solid middle that blotted out the stars. Until Sabrina saw that it was a stealth helicopter. Until it was hovering straight overhead. Until a spotlight fell over her, blinding her. Until the helicopter kept lowering. Until it was almost whipping the pine trees. Until a Out.